The current state of humanoid robots. The robotics industry has achieved some amazing feats of engineering over the last few decades, and many of these achievements have transformed our world for the better. For example, robots are now routinely used in medicine, manufacturing, the military, deep-sea diving, and of course, exploring other planets. However, while the Mars rover or even those giant car assembly robots are undoubtedly impressive, there is one type of robot that forever captivates people's attention, the humanoid bot. Humanoid robots are such amazing demonstrations of our technology that they always feel like they've come straight out of science fiction. But what are the latest developments in humanoid bots? Why do we create them? And what could they do in the future? Let's get into it. The Atlas Robot by Boston Dynamics. In August 2021, Boston Dynamics published new videos showcasing the abilities of its Atlas robot. The first video shows Atlas units demonstrating a parkour routine and doing complex technical moves like flips and vaults, while the second video features the company's engineers explaining Atlas's capabilities. Boston Dynamics has hit the headlines in the past for its dynamic and highly mobile robots, including Spot, Big Dog, Handle, and now Atlas. If you've been on the internet, you've probably seen one of these bots at least once, albeit probably running into a wall multiple times or falling over in a meme. However, despite the funny fail memes, these things are no joke. The current version of Atlas is very impressive, not purely for what you see on the screen, but also because of what you don't see. The engineers explained that earlier editions of the robot were essentially blind. So, while the robots could execute complex moves like running, jumping, rolling, and walking in an eerily human-like way, they were just following pre-programmed rules. However, the new Atlas tech takes it a step further, allowing the robot to use its own perception to navigate and adapt to its environment. Wowza! Now that's sci-fi if I've ever heard of it. Just make sure to be nice to them. Or else. Nadine by Kokoro, Japan. Nadine has been described as a human-like social robot due to its realistic-looking skin, hair, and hands. She can make eye contact, return greetings, remember conversations she's had in the past, and simulate human emotions. If you remember the humanoid robot Sophia from a couple years back, Nadine is very similar. The robot uses 3D depth cameras, webcam, and microphones to understand users and the environment. Therefore, it's thought that Nadine could be used in customer-facing settings, like as a shop assistant in the future. And if you now have the strong urge to meet Nadine, then good news! Nadine is working as a customer service agent in AIA Insurance Company in Singapore. This is the first time in the world that a humanoid robot is used as a customer service agent. Upcoming humanoid robot projects. Elon Musk is best known for two things: random outbursts on Twitter and investing heavily into futuristic projects like driverless cars and Mars colonies. However, for someone so clearly passionate about cutting-edge technology, including AI, he's also somewhat cynical about it. During a speech at the annual summer meeting in the National Governors Association, Musk said,
"I'm really quite close to, I'm very close to the cutting edge in AI, and it scares the hell out of me. It's capable of vastly more than almost anyone knows."
Also, in 2014, he told CNBC's Closing Bell,
"So I think there's potentially a dangerous outcome there, and we need to..."
Dangerous?
Potentially, yes. I mean, there's been movies about this, you know, like Terminator.
Yes, but...
Despite his concerns about a robotic underclass that could take over the world, the Tesla CEO recently unveiled the humanoid robot dubbed the Tesla Bot. The code name for the bot inside the company is Optimus. Optimus reportedly borrows many parts of the AI that is developed for Tesla's autonomous vehicles and will be designed to handle repetitive, dull, or unsafe tasks. So, has Musk had a change of heart when it comes to humanoids? No, it doesn't look like it. During the presentation on the bot, which took place on the 19th of August 2021, Musk stressed that the bot would be friendly. He also pointed out that it will be 5 foot 8 inches and 125 pounds, and you could outrun and overpower it. Musk said that the prototype should be ready sometime next year. Scary or impressive? Perhaps one of the biggest reasons people are so interested in humanoid robots is because they walk that fine line between terrifying and awe-strikingly impressive. Like Musk, many people are worried about the potential for humanoids to become conscious and autonomous. Although we're getting closer every year, we're a long way off from robots that look and behave indistinguishably from humans. However, it's worth considering that even when we get there, human-like AI will probably be more paranoid than you think. Think about it. If the robot has access to the same media we do, it will know that almost every movie created about its kind results in humans mercilessly killing robots that become too conscious or too decisive. So, its best survival strategy would be to keep its head down and keep packing our bags. What are the real-world uses of humanoids? The potential roles that humanoids could play in the world are enormous. For example, several countries are already working on humanoids for space exploration, like India's VAD's Via Mitra. Humanoids could also take the place of people in certain jobs like bartending, shop assistants, receptionists, and nannies. But why humanoids and not just regular robots? Well, we just feel more comfortable about robots that appear more human, providing they don't seem too human, of course. So, that's it for today. What do you think about humanoid robots? Let us know in the comments. If you enjoyed the video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. And if you didn't, just like the video anyways. What's the harm? It's button clicky click. Thanks for watching, and we hope to see you when it's time again for What's Next?